What's the story, Morning Glory? What's the word, Hummingbird? Thank you so much for clicking on my channel and for joining me for this review of Married at First Sight Season 17, episode, I don't know what, the after party. So it's the on the after party, we have obviously Keisha Napoleon, we have Brennan, and we also have Chloe, and we have Cameron. So I was so happy to see Brennan and Cameron because I know that they're going to give us some really good insight on, you know, what the hell was going on with the most recent episode. And of course, it's nice to see Chloe there, but like I said in my review for episode, what is it, 21, Chloe and Michael's story is just being completely drowned out by all the drama. Anyway, so it starts off with they show the clip of Claire talking to us about how she sent Cameron a happy birthday text, but Cameron did not respond. So she's trying to make it seem as if, you know, she's still the caring wife, even though they are separated and not living together. She still cares enough about him to send him a happy birthday text, and he's being so mean by not responding. So when they showed that clip, Cameron says that the reason why he didn't respond was because he was still dealing with his medical issues with his heart, and he was going in and out of the hospital. So this is the reason why he didn't respond to her birthday text. Now, Cameron, you don't have to give us any explanation, because I don't think you should have responded whether you were going in and out of hospitals or you were sitting in your living room on the couch, you know, watching Bugs Bunny cartoons. I don't think you should have responded, because what she did to you was horrible. So then they talk about Becca's cheating. So Brennan said that he and Emily, so the reason why he never brought up the fact that she was making out with some random guy at the bar after she had seen some text messages or some messages between Brennan and other females, the reason why he didn't bring up her kissing this other guy during their marriage, in essence, cheating on him, he didn't bring it up, he said, because him and Emily had made a pact to not say things on camera that would make the other person look bad. And this was a huge, even though he thinks he was doing the right thing for himself, like, hey, you know, don't talk about my crap, I won't talk about yours, I think it was a huge detriment to Brennan, because even though they didn't talk about the real nitty gritty of what was going on, Emily said enough about Brennan to kind of paint him as the bad husband. She said just enough to spin it and twist it to make it seem as if, you know, she was the dutiful wife doing what she was supposed to do, following the expert's instructions, the little bit of instructions that they gave. She was really trying, and he was the one that was turning away from her for no reason, no explanation, because he wasn't telling. And I remember saying this in my previous review. I wish Brennan would talk, not Brennan, I said this about Austin, but it applies to Brennan as well. I wish Brennan would have said more of what was going on between him and Emily, to give us an understanding of why he was acting the way he was acting. But on the after party, he acted as if he liked the idea that they were not going to talk bad about each other, because he was trying to stay true to that decision that they made together as a couple, whereas she was the one that kept on going back and forth on it. So they talk about the whole double date comment. I think it was Cameron that said, yeah, it was Cameron, because he had mentioned this to Claire. And he said that when he mentioned it to Claire, that, you know, him and Brennan talked about going on double dates after this journey was over, he said that Claire laughed. And he says she laughed because I was making a joke. I wasn't dead serious about it. I was just making a joke. And that's the reason why she laughed. She thought it was funny. Now they're using it as a weapon. What Claire found so funny and so hilarious, she turned it around to break Emily's heart by telling Emily, hey, the guy that you are falling for, that you want to stay married to, he's already talking about dating other people while he's still married to you. So not dating other people while he's still married, but talking about it while he's still married. And so, yeah, that's just awful that she takes a joke and then she's like, oh, I cannot wait to tell Emily this is what her husband said. And she knows that it's going to hurt Emily. And so now here we are. Now, I kind of feel like I don't know. I kind of feel like Emily and Claire probably had talked about this before they filmed that part. I think they had discussed it. I think Claire had brought this up to Emily beforehand and said, "Hey girl, this is what Cameron said," even though I know he was just joking. "We can use this against the guys. You know, let's go on camera when it's time for us to film together. Let's bring this up on camera that you're gonna start crying and act really devastated, and I'm gonna act like I'm really affected too, that our husband we're gonna go on these double dates and we're still married to them." And I think I kind of feel like that's how it went down, you know, because I think that's just how conniving these women are. Then they talk about Emily's negativity, and Brandon talks about how this was a red flag for him. And when Emily talked about, but he still doesn't give examples of her being negative other than the comment that she made about Michael's vows to Chloe at their wedding. He doesn't say anything else about her being negative. Like, does she wake up in a grumpy mood? Were you suggesting like fun things to do and she was just like being real negative and didn't want to do anything? Was she like a workaholic and didn't want to spend any quality time? Like, what was she doing other than that comment that she made that you feel like had made her so damn negative? He still doesn't give any other examples about that. When Emily talked about her, because okay, so during the episode when she was FaceTiming, I think it was when she was FaceTiming her friend, she said that her relationship with Brennan was spiraling and had been spiraling. And so when they brought up that clip, Brennan said that she was referring to that's how she began to feel after Claire had told her about the double date comment. That's when he feels like she began to spiral, which, yeah, I agree with him. Yeah, after that's when she was like she had had enough with him, because up until then, it seemed like she was still trying. Okay, someone she was still trying. But then once she got that information from Claire, and you know, Claire lied. Claire said that Brennan had said it, but actually it was Cameron that said it. So when that information was brought to Emily, you know, Emily was kind of like, okay, now I'm really done. All gloves are off now. They talk about the whole video diary thing. You know how Emily had said that Brennan makes her delete her video diary entries where he feels like she's talking too negative about him. And she kind of was trying to use this as an example of how controlling Brennan was. Now, Brennan on the after party had said that no, that's not how it went. Me and her had decided together that she was going to delete some of the footage because when I brought this up to her, how I didn't like how it made me look, you know, she was fine with it. You know, we laughed about it and she deleted it. It was like no big deal when it was actually happening. But then she comes on camera and makes it seem like, well, he's making me delete stuff that's, you know, my own personal truth and it's a part of my journey, but he's making me delete them because it's making him look bad. So it was like a sign of him being controlling. And I remember also how Becca, not Becca, how Claire talked about Cameron being controlling as well. So, yeah. Cameron said the need to keep some things off camera became confusing. Yes, Cameron, because you're an honest person, you're not a pathological liar. So he was talking about how the things that Be that Cam that what's her name? That the things that Claire would want on camera and off camera, he couldn't keep up. He couldn't keep up with what was okay to say on camera and what was not okay to say on camera. He could not keep up. So he would get confusing. And I think that's the reason why a viewer like me was so confused about their relationship, because it seemed like he liked her. He wanted to get closer to her. He wanted to stay with her. But then I would hear things, well, in the after party, you know, Claire said that he called her, he said her butt was too big and he didn't like big butts. And at the after party, Claire said that Cameron rejected her when she tried to make advances towards him. He would reject her. But then, y'all, I'm watching the show and it looked like Cameron was really into Claire. Like, he would have loved for Claire to give him some attention. So I was so confused. So because he was confused, I was confused, and nothing was making any sense. It's like, okay, why is it showing one thing on TV, but then Claire is saying something completely different is going on off camera? You know what I'm saying? I mean, just like with Becca and Austin, it was so confusing to me. Like, y'all, I don't know. So, yeah, he said it was really hard to keep up with all the lies, and you know, that's why everything was so muddled up. Cameron says that, okay, so then Cameron talks about how the girls would make a decision on what guy to attack, you know, that week or that day, who was going to be the villain out of all the guys. And so, like, they would decide, okay, this time we're going to go after Brennan. We're going to make Brennan look bad, and we're all going to gang together, and we're all going to make sure that when we're on camera, we're going to mention Brennan being horrible to Emily. And this was happened with all the guys. He said that this is what they would do. It wasn't necessarily guys versus the girls or girls versus the guys. It was the girls collectively, the girls collectively choosing what husband to attack. Brennan being committed to lying on camera really, so I had said this in my previous review that because Brennan was so committed to portraying a false narrative on camera, I think it hurt him because, like I said, for the longest time, I was supporting Emily until Cameron revealed the truth. I was supporting Emily. And if he was more honest about what was, I mean, come on, you are on a show called Married at First Sight. Okay, and we all know how infidelity affects marriages. And your wife cheats on you and you don't mention it because you don't want her to talk about your bad stuff, so you're not going to talk about her bad stuff. Which is so stupid because at the end of the day, y'all don't even want to be together. So what difference would it have made? What difference would it have made? And also, your wife still made you look bad. Dr. Pia made you look bad. Dr. Pia stayed on you, Brennan. You know, because she was pointing out that you were not being a good husband and you still didn't do anything to try to save yourself. You were still like, I'm not going to say anything because if I say something, it's going to destroy her. Well, just say it. I mean, how bad could it possibly? You barely know the girl. Y'all just met. Like, what do you know about her? It's going to absolutely destroy her. Like, it didn't make any sense at all. I don't know. So I think that Brennan did a huge disservice for himself by not speaking up. He should have said more. He should have said exactly what was going on. It would have made a lot more sense. And now I'm sympathetic to Brennan because I know more information about what was going on. I am more sympathetic. And I could have been this sympathetic towards him throughout the whole entire season if he would have been honest about what was going on. And she would have said, okay, I caught him texting other girls. So then he would have said, well, yeah. So then you left and you're making out with some guy. And yeah, everybody talks about how this information came to him from Claire. And Claire and Emily and Becca are supposed to be these BFFs. But here we have Claire betraying Emily by telling her husband, Claire's telling Cameron what Emily did, which we know that Cameron is going to pass that on to Brennan. So how good of a friend is Claire? She's not trustworthy at all. Everybody should be wary of Claire. Everybody should have their good eye on Claire. Everybody. So she was doing things. And I really wonder, like, was she jealous that Emily got matched with a Brennan? And maybe she felt like it should have been her. And what was so wrong about Cameron? Okay, if y'all don't click. Okay, fine, I get it. But why try to destroy him? Why try to ruin his reputation? You know what I'm saying? If you don't like him, okay, we get it. We've watched this show for years. We know a lot of couples just don't like each other. They just don't mix. There's no chemistry. We get it. But you don't have to destroy him. You don't have to paint this false narrative. You know, make up these false stories to make yourself look good and make him look bad. You don't have to do any of that. So unnecessary. No one is going to make y'all stay together if you don't want to stay together. So I'm wondering if Claire was actually jealous of Emily and wanted Brennan for herself. I really wonder. That thought has been popping up into my head more and more often the more I've been watching, you know, the after party, and more truths are being revealed. You know, surviving Claire should be like a whole show on its own. I'm beginning to like wonder if Claire had a thing for Brennan and maybe she was jealous of Emily. Because I don't get it why she was like hell bent on, you know, making Brennan look bad. Anywho, making Brennan look bad, but in doing that, she's making her own friend look bad. And also, I didn't mention this in my previous review, but something that Becca did that really pissed me off in last week's after party was when they were talking about when, Emily cheating on Brennan, and Cameron had brought that up. And Becca was like, well, what does that have to do with anything? Girl, that has everything to do with everything. Cameron could have been talking about the weather. Okay, y'all could have been having, Keisha Knight Pulliam could have been talking about the weather on that after party stage. And he randomly brings up Emily cheating with some strange Australian guy at a bar. That has everything to do with everything. It's relevant to every single thing. What are you talking about? What does that have to do with anything? Because if it was the other way around, if one of the guys was randomly kissing some girl at a bar, that would be like front page news. That would have been all over the internet. Okay, so stop it, Becca. Like, what does that have to do with it? It has everything. It just shows deceit. It shows falseness. It shows people trying to act like they're really trying for their marriage when they're actually not. People pretending to care when they actually don't. They could care less. They don't give a damn. It has everything to do with everything. Okay, I had to get that off my chest. And that's the end of that, y'all. I cannot wait for the reunion. Like I said in my previous review, for the previous episode, I said at the reunion, I think Claire is going to need some bodyguards. I really do. Anyways, thank you so much for joining me. I really do appreciate it. On your way out, please don't forget to rate the video. If you like this content, please subscribe to my channel, and I'll definitely talk to you later. Bye.